We're joined by the head coach of Wingate Volleyball, Shelton Collier, ahead of the 2021 spring season. Coach, this is uncertain times that we are in, but very thankful that you all have a season just like the other sports here on campus. How are you feeling about your team entering this particular season?
I think maybe, first of all, we're just appreciative and feel fortunate that we're able to play. I mean, I think there was some time when we thought, you know, seasons would get wiped out. We certainly didn't play in the fall. We knew last spring a lot of the spring sports got canceled. We had a lot of empathy for all those players that didn't get a chance to play their season. And we didn't really know if the conference would support fall sports playing in the spring until they did. And so I just think we're all appreciative and thankful that we get to play, and we're hopeful that our team stays healthy and the other team stays healthy and that we actually get to play games. I know our players are really fired up about having a chance to play, so we're looking forward to it.
That's awesome. So this past fall, obviously, that's when you normally would play. What were the things that you all were doing? How did you strategize the fall semester? Were you able to practice? Were there a lot of individual workouts? Walk me through how the fall went.
Yeah, our team was incredibly motivated. I was really impressed with them, actually. We came back from summer in really good physical condition. We had some really good leadership. In the fall, we had some really good practices. And, you know, I told them every week, I said, this is really pretty impressive that we're not preparing for an opponent next week, but we're really motivated and we're playing some really high-level volleyball and playing hard in practice. And I just thought it was good by them, because I think it would have been difficult maybe for some teams to say, well, if we can't play in the fall, we'll probably go 50% in practice effort and then just see where it goes in the spring. But we worked pretty hard in the fall and made some good progress, and some players stood out and did really well. So I was really impressed and happy with how we managed that part of it.
Shifting towards off the court, Coach, is there anything that you learned about your team, whether it just comes to chemistry or things you learned about yourself as a coach given all this off time?
Yeah, I think, you know, me, players, everybody in the country had to do some self-check on what just happened with everything. I guess what I learned is, as coaching, you know, we never know how adaptable we're going to have to be until it happens. And coaches always think, oh, we'll be adaptable, but this really hit us and everybody had to adapt. And then I think with our players, they had a couple routes they could have taken. They could have stayed in touch, kept their leadership, really worked at team dynamics, or they could have checked out for a little while. And our team really had good leadership. They really worked at staying in touch and communicating and still getting our team dynamics, even it was over Zoom calls. And I think they did a really good job with that. So I guess, you know, what this has taught us all is, you know, you just have to be flexible and adaptable and kind of accepting of the circumstances and try to make the best of it. So, you know, I think every coach in the world is saying control the controllables, and we did too, and our team did a pretty good job of that.
How would you describe the dynamic of this team, and what are some areas, whether it's offense, defense, serving, that have stood out to you in the preseason?
I think we have a pretty good, solid volleyball team. You know, it's going to be interesting because we haven't played. We've just been playing against each other in scrimmages. So in some ways we have some confidence, and then in some ways we have this thing, well, we have to see how good we're going to be when we play somebody else. So I think it's kind of a mix of confidence along with some apprehension, and I guess that's only natural. But I think we have pretty good players at a number of positions. I don't think our team's built around one or two, three players that are going to carry us. So I guess what we're trying to do as a team is kind of have an ensemble cast where everybody knows their roles and everybody has to really do their thing for us to be good. But on the other side of that, if we have some players that don't do their thing, our team can go south quick because we don't have a lot of star players right now that carry us. We have to have a collaboration of players that really do a good job for each other. And so we've been really emphasizing that as we've been practicing.
We know that the starting setter position is solidified with Shannon Kasprak. What are your expectations from her this season, and how much has she grown since she stepped foot here on campus?
Yeah, I said, you know, when I said that we have an ensemble cast and a collaboration of players, that kind of revolves around Shannon. I think she's our standout player. She's been probably the person running our gym, if I had to name one player most impressive to me, it's Shannon, with her work ethic, her development, her improvement, her leadership, how she plays. So I think at that position, we go into matches thinking that we have a special player that really has some great qualities that can lead us. And then around her, we have a lot of moving parts that that have to really play at a high level to help her. But Shannon certainly has been a player that I think to our whole team and to me as a coach has really stood out with her effort, her enthusiasm, her competitiveness, and her level of play. And it's really been rewarding to see.
We know, of course, Mariana Warren had that devastating knee injury back in 2019, so over a year and a half ago. What's her recovery been like, and what's it been like getting to see her step back on the court?
Yeah, she's been working hard to get back in, and you know, she hits a heavy ball, and she can be an offensive factor, and we've been using her with her jump serve. I know that that's been a factor in some matches, so we're working her way back in, and she's not back at probably 100% yet, but she's back to being able to play, and she's contributing for sure, and she's playing in some moments for us, and when she gets her arm going, she can be pretty good, so we're looking forward to seeing where that goes when we get in some matches.
Let's talk about your pin hitters. What can we expect from that group?
Well, Molly Lambelot's kind of one of the keys to our team. She kind of does it all, and she plays all the time, and she's one of our highest IQ players and one of our most consistent players, so we kind of build a lot around her. And Reese Blackley has really evolved into a stronger outside hitter. Both of them played last year, but they knew that they had to elevate their game this year for us. So Reese Blackley has been impressive there. And Ann Abernathy is our starting opposite, and this is her fourth year, and she's been here forever. So she's got an experience and kind of plays with a veteran savvy to her. And Lorna Stokerski is a freshman who's going to be really good, and she's working hard, and she's pushing and playing well. So we have a combination of players that will play there, and we're looking forward and see how they do.
How do you feel about your defense and the defensive specialist spot?
Yeah, one factor we kind of lucked into was a transfer of Courtney Neeson, and she has a lot of experience. She was one of the leaders in digs and in the country at her former school. So wow. She came to Wingate because her school canceled volleyball, and so she's here now. And it didn't take her too long to win the libero position. We didn't exactly know what was going to happen with it because Treslin Ortiz graduated, was our libero last year. And so we have Carrie Bogan from Norway. She came in. Taryn Price as a freshman. She's coming in. She's challenging for it. We have Casey Eastland. We have Maggie Mullen. So we have a lot of different defensive people that are all sharing different responsibilities back there. But Courtney Neeson kind of nailed down the libero position, and she's a really solid kid with a lot of experience. But we're trying to groom other players because the reality is Courtney's not coming back in the fall. Mm-hmm. This is her final season this spring. So we've got to cultivate some other players to begin to accept that responsibility as well. So we're doing both of those things at the same time.
Last question, what's your message to your team before this first match? Because I can imagine that some of the student-athletes, at least, it's going to hit them a little bit different given the amount of time that they've had off from playing a different colored jersey. So what's the message to the team before this first one?
Well, before I answer that question, I'm going to have to mention that we have middle blockers. We have Quinn Supton. She's a transfer from Kennesaw State, mm-hmm. really good player. And we've got a couple freshmen, Caroline Poor, Ray Givens. They're working hard as freshmen, so they're kind of the future of the position. I think with Sophie Schaff, we've got a really good leader and a really good player that's been around. And Maggie Young had a great freshman year last year, so we're really confident how they're going to do. And, you know, it's interesting, we're going to play Lenoir Ryan, and it's our first match of the season, and it'll be their third match.
Yeah.
They played last night, and they play tonight. So they're going to have kind of the nervous jitters out already, and they'll have already played some matches and gone through different live situations, and we will not have done any of that, and we're just going to go out and play. So, you know, we're kind of aware that they'll come in maybe with a little confidence after playing two matches, and you know, but the other thing is we'll be jacked up in our own gym, and hopefully we're going to be able to have some students there. We've heard the attendance policy might be relaxed a little bit, and if we have some students there and some support and we get our gym going a little bit, you know, that's really good for us.
But at the same time, like.
Yeah, but at the same time, we're playing a team that just played two matches, and they've already troubleshooted their things, and, mm-hmm. you know, we could get in a couple jams out there, and it'd be our first time going through it together, and we won't have a chance to troubleshoot it. We'll have to do it on the fly, so it'll be interesting. I just know our team's fired up about playing and playing. You know, we get to play at home and we get to play. So
yeah.
Well, they're looking forward to that.
The countdown is on, Coach. We appreciate your time and best of luck this season.
All right. Thank you.